Hello everyone, Justin DeLay from Reverb Sync here, and today we're going to talk about something that I personally really love, which is MIDI, generally speaking, but specifically MIDI controllers. The cool thing about a MIDI controller is that, well, first of all, they come in all shapes and sizes. Today, we're gonna take a look at just the very basics of using MIDI controllers to really, I think, transform the experience of using any kind of music software, but today we're gonna specifically look at Ableton Live. So, first things first, what is a MIDI controller? Well, it usually looks something like this. Generally speaking, you're gonna have some keys, you maybe have some drum pads, you maybe have some faders and some knobs, and all of these are tactile inputs that send signals into your recording software that then again you can use to play it as an instrument, to control maybe the mix, to control effects, etc. The majority of MIDI controllers these days are gonna be USB driven. Some MIDI controllers also use old school MIDI DIN jacks. So how does it work? Well, first things first, you plug it in. In Ableton Live specifically, we're gonna go to preferences as usual. We're gonna get this out of the way. And what we're looking for here is the link/MIDI tab. Ableton Live does a really, really nice job of supporting MIDI controllers specifically right out of the box, which is pretty rad, which means that they've already kind of gone through and done a lot of the hard work of getting everything set up. In our case, we're using the AKI MPK61, really sweet controller, but you know, again, you could use anything that'll work for you. And it just so happens to be totally built into Ableton Live here. So we're just gonna click on MPK61 on the control surface. And that's it. That is truly it. You say what control surface you're using, you say what port is going in, what port is going out, and now we've got MIDI data flowing. You now have a control surface for your tracking, right? It's super, super useful. You don't have to hit the space bar. You can actually even be looking at your computer, which to me is the most valuable aspect of all of this, is that you can transition your experience of using music software away from a mouse, a trackpad, a keyboard, and making it really kind of feel like work to something that feels like an instrument. This is pretty cool. I'm gonna hit play, and you'll see that these faders here are already mapped to the first 8 channels of Ableton Live. Now, we're only using 2 at the moment, so you're gonna see that when I move this fader here, if we watch over here on the screen, we're gonna see the fader actually go down and we're controlling the volume level of our loop, right? Pretty rad. And then of course we can bring it back up. And let it stop. Wow, think about that. That's so crazy. We basically now have a mixer and this is all built in. Now, what happens if we want to do something a little more custom, right? We wanna kind of customize how this all works. What we're gonna do is we're gonna put a filter, our lovely Atom filter from our friends at Sine Vibes. We're just gonna drag and drop that onto our drum beat there. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna map the filter cutoff to a knob so that you can sort of sweep the filter, right, with a knob. I'm going to go into the MIDI mapping mode, which I do by clicking up here in the top where it says MIDI. I'm gonna click there. And now you see anything that's MIDI mappable is blue, is highlighted blue. What we are going to do is just click on filter frequency here and move it around a little bit. And you can see down here that the resonance is moving and the cutoff is moving, right? So is we're gonna click down here on the filter cutoff and we're going to map it to, we'll map it to this knob here. Just pull up a simple piano sound so that we can just get a sense for, you know, what this is like to play with. We're gonna just search for a piano here in Ableton. Let's try an FM piano, see what that sounds like. Right, so pretty sweet. You know, you can play virtual instruments from a keyboard if you want, but nothing beats having an actual keyboard interface. And you know, it lets you just kind of forget about all this stuff and sort of play it like it's a piano. Let's take a look now at the drum pads. Some controllers are going to have drum pads, and we are going to just pull up a simple drum sound. I'm a big fan of the Roland TR-707 style drum machine, and Ableton Live is nice enough to include a really nice set of samples of the 707. What is awesome about this is that, given that this is already mapped to everything in Ableton Live, all you gotta do is add a new 707 track, and then this is perfectly mapped to the sounds of the 707. So, for instance, some MIDI controllers are just pad controllers, actually. You can just get a grid of pads, which is really, really fun to just add. You know, if you've already got a keyboard, adding a pad controller can really open up a whole new expressive element to your playing. So that is that's it for today. Again, I'm Justin DeLay from Reverb Sync. We took a look at Ableton Live MIDI controllers, and I hope you have fun. Thanks.